Let's understand the PMT function today. A lot of times we face a very important question whenever we are making a decision about buying a house or buying a car or maybe making another investment. And a lot of times it is financed by a loan. For example, if I am buying a house worth a crore of rupees, that is about 10 million rupees, and the bank is willing to fund about 60 lakh rupees out of this, which is 6 million rupees, I want to find out often that what is going to be my monthly outflow for this loan. So let's put this example here. The loan amount is equal to 2%. Let's say the rate of interest that is being charged by the bank is about 12% per annum, which will be about 1% per month. Let's not get into the complications of the effective rate of interest right now. Let's just simply say that it is 1% per month. And the bank is willing to give me a period or tenure of 20 years for this loan. This is equal to 240 months. Now, what PMT function of Excel does is it gives me the payment or EMI or equated monthly installment that I have to pay to the bank on account of this loan, which will go towards the principal and interest of the loan. So the way PMT function syntax reads is like this. You'll notice the moment you start typing, Excel prompts you and Excel helps you with all the prompts for the respective fields. The PMT function starts with rate as the first field. So you have to enter 1% per month as the rate in this field. Why 1% and why not 12%? Because we want to find out the EMI, that is equated monthly installment. If we put 12% as the rate, then we'll have to put corresponding period as 20 years, and what we'll get is the annual installment and not the monthly installment. So let's put rate as 1% here. The second field here is the NPER, that is the period of our loan. The period here is 240 months. So we'll put that here. And the third field here is PV, which is the current value of the loan, the present value of the loan. So PV is the field here. After this, you can see that there are two more optional fields. One is FV, which is future value. By default, the value of this is zero. That is, the loan has to be completely repaid over a period of 240 months in this case. So even if you don't put anything here, the default value of zero is considered. The last part in the formula is the type. Now what is this? It has two possible values, zero or one. The default value here is zero. Zero signifies the end of the period calculation. That means the formula assumes that you are paying the installment at the end of the period, which may be a month, quarter, or a year. While one assumes that you are paying the installment at the beginning of the period. So please note that if you enter zero or if you do not enter anything here, the default value is zero. And that is the end of the period payment. Now, let's understand two peculiarities of this formula. Don't be surprised if you get negative answer as a result of this formula. The answer will be in red within parentheses. This signifies an outflow. This is because the formula assumes that 6 million of loan is an inflow and the EMI, that is the equated monthly installment, is going to be an outflow or a payment. And the payment is indicated in the form of a negative number here. If you want a positive number here, please specify the amount as a negative number. That is, add a minus sign to the PV in the formula. Second important thing, whenever you have to find out equated monthly installment or equated quarterly installment, all you need to do is adjust the rate and the period in the formula accordingly. For example, in our case, the rate of interest was 12% per annum and we wanted to calculate equated monthly installment. There are 12 months in the year. That's why we divided the rate by 12. Similarly, we multiplied the period by 12. If you want to find out quarterly installments, what will you do? You will divide the rate by 4 and you will multiply the period by 4, because in a year there are 4 quarters. Always note that the total of equated monthly installments in a year will never be equal to the amount which is calculated as equated installment per annum. That is because of the principle of present value playing out. We'll understand more about this concept in our sessions on finance. So what have we got? 66,065 rupees. Oh, that's a big EMI that we've got. And that is on top of 40% down payment that you had to make. Remember, the house was for 1 crore of rupees, that is 10 million rupees, and you had paid 4 million rupees as a down payment and you got a loan of only 6 million rupees. So that's it. The PMT function will allow you to understand what is going to be your outflow based on the loan amount, the rate of interest, and the period of the loan. A lot of times we face a unique problem. In this case, we know the solution, we know the answer, but we want to find out the inputs to this answer. For example, I want to buy a house and I know that I can allocate only rupees 50,000 per month in the form of EMI or equated monthly installment for this house. This is after allocating all the expenses towards running my house, my day-to-day expenses and my savings, right? So how do I find out how big a house I can buy or how big a loan I can take if I know that I can spend only 50,000 rupees in the form of equated monthly installment? So let's go back to our PMT example. In this case, we have loan amount of 60 lakh rupees, that is 6 million rupees. And we know that the EMI for this loan at the rate of 12% and for a 20-year loan is 66,000 rupees. How will I find out the amount of loan that gives me exact 50,000 rupees as EMI? I'll go to the loan cell or the loan amount cell. I'll manually change the loan amount and by a trial and error method, I'll find out the EMI amount. So till the time I don't reach that loan amount exactly, which gives me 50,000 rupees of EMI, I will continue to do the trial and error, right? This is where the goal seek function of Excel helps you out. It gives you that value of input which is necessary to get an exact output amount. Where is goal seek in Excel? Go to the data tab and go inside the what if analysis. The shortcut is Alt-A-W-G. There are three steps in goal seek. First one, set the cell to a value. Now, what is this? Here, you give a reference to the output cell, in this case, the EMI cell or the calculated cell. Please note, this cell has to have a formula. Second, set this cell to which value? In this case, we'll say minus 50,000, which is the EMI payment that we have to make. This cannot be a reference, you have to specify a value here. And the third important step, by changing which cell, you have to give a reference to the input cell here. In our case, it will be the loan amount cell. So give all of these references properly. You can also use the normal edit mode of Excel to put in all of these values and just say okay. So what have you got? You've got the answer to your calculation right in one single step. You have saved all of your steps of trial and error method, right? So the answer here is 45,40,971 rupees. That is 4.5 million rupees. So you know the precise amount of loan that you can take to afford an EMI of 50,000 rupees per month. Let's say my family wants a bigger house. They can't take a smaller house. So what do I do? In this case, I have to request the bank for a 25-year loan maybe instead of a 20-year loan. How will I find out the exact tenure? The same way, avoid the trial and error method and use goal seek. However, the changeable input in this case will be period and not the loan amount. All right?